An Idiot's Guide. This week, An Idiot's Guide to Getting Away. With your host, Stephen K. Amos.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Life, An Idiot's Guide. Is everyone here in a good mood?
Yeah!
Yeah. Is everyone here from Edinburgh?
Yeah!
Anyone here from England?
Yeah!
Fight! Well, we can take it back. Awkward. So we've got people from Edinburgh, people from England, anyone from further afield?
Yeah.
Where?
Faith!
Did you understand the question? I'm from Faith! Anybody from further afield? Yeah, where are you from, say? Just putting your hand up. Where are you from?
Faith.
You're from Faith as well? Am I in the right meeting? Faith! Faith! So this is my Idiot's Guide. And what I've done is I've gathered together some of the finest stand-ups at this year's Edinburgh Fringe, and tonight, since it's summer holiday season, we present An Idiot's Guide to Getting Away. So here I am, a self-confessed idiot, hopefully in a room full of other self-confessed idiots. Am I right?
Yes!
Anyone here from Fife?
Yes.
Now, most people traditionally go away on holiday in August, but not us comics. No, no, no. We come up here to Bonnie Scotland, where it's virtually impossible to get away from anything apart from maybe the sun. And a bit of decorum on a Saturday night. But if you love rain, woohoo! This is the place to be. Now, my legs are absolutely knackered from having to walk up and down the hills and the cobbled streets of Edinburgh all day. I say, scrap the tram. Yeah?
Yeah.
And let's invest in travelators. I know for a fact that a lot of you Edinburgh people are very good at getting away, especially at this time in August, when they can get away with charging £3,000 a week for their flats. I know that, I've paid it. I love getting away now because when I was a kid, we did not go on holidays.
Aww.
I know, awful, because lots of people think they need to get away from it all so they take their families on expensive holidays, right? But my parents realised that they'll be spending too much money, and for what? Because all the things that made them want to get away from it all were just becoming with them. They had 7 kids. Add Cura and Ribena into the mix. But my mum gave me some good advice. She said to me, when you go away, never, ever, ever say you're English. Say you're from Scotland. It saves a lot of bother. I found that doesn't work in Scotland. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my first guest onto the stage tonight, the very, very funny Susan Calman.
Susan Calman. We're talking tonight about getting away. To be honest, I don't really like getting away. I like staying exactly where I am. The main reason I don't like getting away is, as Stephen was talking about, family holidays. Two words that should not go together. Like the words comfortable tights. The thing is, my family hate excitement and hate uncertainty. If you want to be spontaneous with my family, you have to inform us 6 months in advance. As a result, we hated anything that might be slightly dangerous or exotic, destinations like Venezuela, Istanbul, or Devon. So on our family holidays, we went to the same place for 10 years. The same island off the coast of Scotland for 10 years. The holiday would always start with my mother, because if you go on holiday, you have to go on a ferry. You have to go on a ferry, right? Okay? And my mother would always say, oh, it's just like going abroad. As if by saying, oh, it's just like going abroad, we would forget we weren't going abroad. And I don't know if you've ever been on a Scottish ferry, but it's not like going abroad. The most cosmopolitan thing they have is crinkle-cut chips. So we would go to this island off the coast of Scotland. Very, very beautiful, beautiful island. But dear God in heaven, it was like Groundhog Day, but less exciting. If a groundhog had popped up, at least I would have had someone to play swing ball with. I don't know if you've ever tried to play yourself at swing ball for 10 years, but it's difficult to let yourself win every single time. One of the good things, though, I think if you're Scottish and you went on a Scottish family holiday every year, it was magic, right? Because the weather is absolutely appalling, but it doesn't put a dampener on the Scottish holiday, especially in the 1970s, when parents had scant regard for health and safety issues. I recall clearly one time we climbed a mountain, not a hill, a mountain, clad only in Wellington boots and our school jumpers. There's a photo of us at the top of the mountain in a blizzard. A blizzard! And we're all smiling in the photograph because for a Scottish family, the worst thing you can do is make a fuss. You're on your holiday, smile for the photograph. And there's a photograph of us. It's the kind of photo you might see in a True Life magazine under the headline, "The Parents Who Walked Their Children to Death." You may not also know, but in Scotland we have something called the North Sea, where we have oil rigs. We have oil rigs, and the people who work in the oil rigs are given survival suits. Because if you fall in the North Sea in around 2 minutes, you will lose consciousness and die. The same North Sea we were forced to swim in for hours, wearing only a bathing suit with an orange dinghy for protection. And we were on an island, and it rained a lot, and as Scottish people aren't particularly good, right, sometimes a wee fiery ball appears in the sky and all the men take their tops off and looks like pieces of cheese sweating out of the fridge for too long. So I don't really like getting away. Now when I see the rain, it does feel like a Scottish summer holiday. I pretend to have fun. I set up a camera to take a picture of myself in a bikini while the rain is lashing outside, and then I play some swing ball. Myself. Thank you very much for listening to me. I've been Susan Calman.
Yes, that was Susan Calman, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all very much. Now, money was quite tight in our household. My parents used to buy and sell houses, so we moved around constantly when I was a kid. They thought of themselves as property developers. We thought we were in the witness protection program. So what I did as a kid, I ran away from home. Yeah, well, I should say I actually walked, because to run implies that someone was chasing you going, "Don't leave us, we love you." That was not the case. I was about 9 or 10, and I thought, I'd teach my parents a lesson. I'd get some attention. I'd get them worried sick. I got as far away as my next door neighbor's garden. But did my parents look for me? Did they hell? I waited 6 hours, nothing. 20 hours, now I'm freezing. I went back 24 hours later, went back to the house, they'd moved. Some of you may know that you were handed questionnaires as you came in, and one of the questions I asked on the questionnaire was, have you ever run away from home, and how far did you get? Is there a Catherine Elliot in the house?
Yes.
Yes. What did you say?
I said, I ran away from home, but I only got to the end of the road because I wasn't old enough to cross it on my own.
Thank you, Catherine. Is there a Rachel G in the house?
Yes.
Yes. Can you remember your answer to that question?
I used to practice running away. I never actually got round to it, but we used to practice with a napkin tied onto a stick with our stuff in it.
God bless you for your honesty. And also, do we have a Bill G? Is he with you? Oh, they are. What he's got down here is, the question was, have you ever run away from home? And how far did you get? Yes, but not far. The chain was too short. Did you live inside the house?
It was Faith.
Well done. Please welcome my next guest, someone who's chosen to get away by travelling all the way from California to Scotland. Please welcome W. Kamau Bell.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.